how's the knee feeling, and you know, what's it like to get back out on the court in 2019?
Yeah, I'm feeling good. Feeling really good. Starting to get back. I'm 100% really right now. So I'm just happy to be out there, man. Just being out there with my teammates, talking, just having fun. Just sitting out for so long, it makes you realize how much you miss the game, and really just get back to. I just love playing. That's all it is. So.
When you go through an injury like that, what's the hardest part of the journey? The mental side of it, or the physical getting back?
For me, it was more the mental side, because I just wanted to get back so bad, and I created an expectation for myself that I was gonna try and reach some goal to get back before the season end. And when I saw that wasn't gonna be reality, I started just mentally just kind of feeling bad about myself. And so I think it was the hardest part for me was being mentally, because the physical part you control it, but it's kind of out of your control on the same type of way, because you don't want to rush back too fast and then injure yourself even more. So I just took my time and came back good.
How emotional was that first, I guess, on court work that you did? What was that moment like for you getting back on the court?
Yeah, I mean, it felt really good, obviously, because it's been so long. I mean, I probably didn't look as good as I was before because I was out of rhythm and everything. But I mean, even if I made a mistake, which I did, I was just happy to be out there. It wasn't, yeah.
Did you ever worry about possibly re-injuring? Did you ever hesitate or anything like that, or you've gone full bore?
Yeah, I mean, with me, it did take a little bit for me to start trusting it a little bit, because I had also gotten hurt my high school season in high school, and this one was probably more where I had to trust it, like, way more. Like, it was harder for me to trust it, and I just had to find that belief in myself where I'm just like, okay, I'm over it. You know, like, I'm good, so.
Yesterday, Frank talked about how big of a voice you were on the bench last year, even though you were out. Does being a leader come naturally to you? Has that always been a natural position for you?
Yeah, I mean, I've always enjoyed being a leader. I think I've always had leadership skills. I think I just be positive, really. That's all I try and do. It's not too hard for me to become. I just think I'm trying to stay positive, trying to stay loud, keep my energy, and just compliment guys and make sure, like, no guy gets too low. And, I mean, I guess that's being a good leader by doing that. But I just feel like that's what every teammate should do, being a good teammate.
Sorry, man. What do you think the strength of this offense is this year?
I think we got a lot of great pieces. Our guard play is really good. All of our guards, our practices are all competitive, too, with the guards and even the bigs. I just think it's, like, real competitive. So I think that's our biggest strength, because we got a bunch of guys who are just dogs. So I'm excited.
What's the hardest part of adjusting when you lose a piece like Chris Silva?
He does so many things, so it's a big adjustment at the rim, the defensively and stuff. But our team is just adjusted, because I remember being a freshman going up against Chris Silva, getting blocked and everything. Like, it was just so hard to get to the rim. But the same type of things is happening to our guards now with Wildens, and they're all blocking shots. So it's not too big of an adjustment. So
you got a lot of minutes, obviously, as a freshman. You got a bunch of minutes last year before you got hurt. Mm-hmm. Frank talked about how, you know, obviously it's natural for everybody to want 30-plus minutes, mm-hmm. right? On this team, that's going to be hard because of the pieces.
Yeah.
Is there a challenge there, maybe with some of the younger guys particularly, maybe someone like you that's been used to a lot of minutes that might have to have more of a diminished role, but less of a minute total because of the depth there?
Yeah. I think there's always a challenge whenever you're expecting some type of playing time, but really I'm just listening to whatever the coach has got to do and whatever they put us, whatever position they put me in and how many minutes I got to play to help the team. That's just where I'm at.
How does that fit maybe how you guys want to play, though, the way you guys want to run up and down the floor, and all those pieces can help, correct?
Yeah. And I mean, if we're going to be running up the floor a lot, that's also mean guys are going to start getting tired. So, I mean, if we're running up and down in transition a lot, it can only help us to be able to get out, get a quick breather, get right back in.
Do you expect that style?
Yeah.
Yeah,
I think so, yeah.
Why specifically?
Just because of our team. I think our personality of our team is way more faster, athletic than it was my freshman year. So I think just the speed of our team and all that's more of our style that's going to be. Because, I don't know, I think, were we the fastest team at SEC last year, I think?
Close to, yeah.
So, and got the same type of guys, so it's going to be exciting.
They talked about maybe your role, whether you play the three, the four, kind of where they see you fitting into this puzzle.
No, we haven't talked about it yet. Right now, I'm just practicing, just at the three right now. I have to play the four. I'm good, whatever the team really needs. So.
How often are you and Keisha on the floor at the same time?
We're on the floor a good amount at the same time. We also go back and forth at each other. It's really good. All of us, me, Keisha, and Jermaine. None of it is like like, oh, I'm fighting for this playing time, I'm fighting for this playing time. Like, we're all helping each other out. Like, Keyshawn does something good, I'm right in his ear, like, good job, boy. He does the same to me, so it's none of that. Yeah.
Your shot right now.
Mm-hmm. Feels good. My shot feels really good. I feel like I got a lot of confidence right now. And like I said, I'm just happy to be out there right now. It's just just ecstatic.
Do you talked about putting expectations on yourself.
Mm-hmm.
When you were injured, do you put any extra added expectation on yourself going into this season, or how hard is that to do? Mm-hmm. You know, when you're coming off, you know, an injury.
Yeah, no, I'm not putting any expectations on myself at all. I'm just taking it day by day, playing hard, and that's all I'm doing right now. I did that the first time. I didn't enjoy it.
What's the next step for your game? Is it mm-hmm. just improving the shot, improving your offense? What, mm-hmm. just what kind of are you working on?
Yeah, just become. I'm trying to become a way better like rebounder. I'm trying to become one of the best rebounders on the team. Defensively, trying to become one of the best defenders on the team, and definitely trying to play off the dribble. Trying to become way better off the dribble. So,
how do you evaluate all your point guard options at this point? Is it like a variety of people bring it up from time to time? Is it just kind of strictly AJ, Jair, Trey?
Yeah, there's a variety of guys. We got so many point guards. We got TJ, who's doing great. AJ can go either two or one, doing both. Jair's been looking really good, really solid. And same with Trey Hannibal. He's just athletic, strong. So we got all different types of point guards. So I like that.
What are your impressions of Micaiah?
Micaiah, he's good, really good. He's a strong player. I think he plays really good in the post. And he's a presence at the rim whenever you're driving. So I think he's going to be really helpful for us.
Frank said when he's on the court, he looks like he's a graduate. Like he mm-hmm. you can tell he's experienced. Do you get that sense when you're playing with him?
Yeah, I think so. So he's been in school for like 4 years, so he's experienced. He knows. So he knows what this is all about. So I think he's going to do some really good things for us.
Story behind the necklace. What's
up? Oh, right here. So this my uncle. He actually passed away October 7th, a couple of 4 years ago. And he was always talking about peace, love, and happiness. So I got this, and then he had a panther tattoo. So this one right here is a Black Panther of a ring he had. And I got him tatted on me, too, right here. So, yeah. Yeah, appreciate that.